Alamance County is pleased to present the Alamance County Commissioners Meeting.
I'd like to welcome everyone to our January 19th meeting at Alamance County Commissioners, our first meeting of the new year. This time, please join me in the invocation. Father God, we just thank you, Lord, for the many blessings that each one of us received. Lord, as we come to you now, Father, I just, in this cold weather, I pray for the poor and the seniors, Lord, and just pray that you'd keep them safe. Father, we just pray that your blessings on our military as they serve our country and keep us safe overseas and abroad. And Lord, I just pray now for this Board of Commissioners, Lord, as we do the people's business, Lord, just pray that you'd guide us and direct us in this endeavor. Father, we thank you for loving us, and Lord, these things I do pray in your name. Amen.
Amen.
Please stand for a Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Please be seated. We have, ladies and gentlemen, four public speakers tonight. The first is Angela Kalo, and she was she called a few minutes ago, was unable to make it, but she sent Mr. Bird just a very brief message that he would like to share.
She says, "Good evening. I had plans to attend the county commissioners meeting tonight, and now I cannot. I actually signed up for a time to speak, and I apologize that I can't be there. I was coming to show my support for a new animal shelter building to be joined to the Pet Adoption Center. I am active in rescue, and I deeply admire the commitment of the shelter staff in caring for these animals. I know that it's a challenge in the current facilities. The potential to save and treat more animals would be there if we could consolidate both facilities and there was room for on-site veterinary services and spray, neuter, and more room for adoptable animals. Our shelter has done a great job reducing the euthanasia rate, and the proposed building would make it even lower. Thank you all for taking an active leadership role in trying to expand our shelter. It is very much appreciated by the citizens of our county, and this citizen in particular. Best regard, Angela Kalo."
Thank you, Mr. Bird. Next we have Tim Britt. Major.
Thank you, Chairman. Tim Britt with the Sheriff's Office. I'd like to take just a moment to share with you an experience I had today and also recognize some very special citizens in our community. Today I had the great opportunity of going out to the village at Brookwood, where I got to meet these fine young ladies right here, and they have started a community project where they're making quilts, handmade quilts and stuffed animals, and providing them to our officers so that when we come across a traumatized child, we have a blanket to wrap them in, or we have an animal to give them, a stuffed animal. And I think it'd be better to let them introduce themselves, but I think this is a great example of when our citizens come forward and help us in making our community a better place to live. And this is why Alamance County is great. Thank you, ladies.
Thank you, Major Britt. My name is Janice McSherry, and they nominated me as a spokesperson for Benny Hall, Gloria
Stovkin,
Kay Wren, and Carolyn Rimmer, and myself are the seamstress. Angela Wren and her daughter. Angela donated all the bears, and her young daughter, Allison, we're teaching her to quilt. But this is something we wanted to do for our community, to give back to the community. We do other community projects as well, but this is important to us because our children are the future of our communities, and we are extremely fortunate in Alamance County to have the law enforcement agencies such as the sheriff and the sheriff's officers and deputies that have the compassion that we were shown today for their jobs and for the citizens of Alamance County. And for that, we are extremely thankful. And thank you, Mr. Commissioner, Mr. Chairman, for allowing us to come and y'all recognize us for our work. We didn't do this in any way to get recognition, but it's something we all felt very strongly about, giving back to our community. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you, ladies. And I'm going to break rank with, if it's okay with the commission, I'd like to say a couple words, ladies, as you're fixing to leave. You know, as a law enforcement officer, 40 years and 11 years as a patrol officer in Burlington, there's many occasions when these patrol officers out here in the field, they run into a situation where there's a child that's distressed or a mother that's distressed. I know I've seen officers take their cruiser jacket off and you place them over to mother. And this is really good, ladies. I just want to thank you again. Thank you very
Thanks
much.
So much.
Appreciate it. Thank you. Next we have Mr. Tony Cox. He's in the back room, so we'll give him just a second.
Somebody back for those people right there.
They're outside, Tony.
How about you do it, Tony? They're right here.
Fine gesture, sir.
What that gets you?
I couldn't stand it back there. Hearing them people about them kids is tough. I try to give when I can. Big government equals big secrets equals big bad things. You know, I come in here and do what I do, and I was forced into this place down here. Forced into it. Back last year, I got an anonymous complaint against me and my business. Friday, I was in a meeting. Here comes a letter. I'll show you everything I got. Whose name do I see? Mr. Clyde Albright. With his claims again. Bring your letters and stuff on out and share them with us, Mr. Albright. That man needs to resign. He should be in jail. I have a right under my constitutional rights to come down here and do this. This man, he has chased me for years now. He's lied on me and lied on me and lied on me.
You're good, Tim.
3 minutes. It's time to stop him. We all know it. It's time to stop him. Resign. Just get out of the county.
Thank you, Mr. Cox. Have a seat.
I have a right to be at this podium for 3 minutes. I have a right. Is my 3 minutes up?
Pretty close.
Next we have Amy Gailey.
Good evening. Just very briefly, I wanted to introduce myself to the folks. I'm Amy Scott Gailey, and I'm a Republican candidate for county commissioner running for the March 15th primary. And tonight I wanted to express my support for the new animal shelter and adoption center. Listen to the comments that were read by Commissioner Byrd, that originated from Angela Kahlo, whose children actually are friends with my children, both of them. And I agreed with what Ms. Kahlo said, that I thought she phrased it very well. There are quite a few people who are going to speak on this issue tonight who have a lot of information to present. I just wanted to voice my support. We have three animals at my house right now. Two cats and a dog who came from the animal shelter, and they're just as much a part of my family as I know all of your creatures are a part of your family. So I just thank you for having me tonight, and I wish you all good luck in getting the funding that you need.
Thank you. Appreciate it. All right, do we have any commissioners' responses? Hearing none. Next on the agenda, we have approval of the agenda. Do I have a motion approving the
agenda? Make a motion to approve the agenda.
Have a second?
I second it.
All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Thank you. Item number six, the consent agenda. Members, trust you've had the opportunity to read over the consent agenda. Is any items to be pulled from the consent agenda? Hearing none?
I move we approve the consent agenda.
Motion, do I have a second? All those in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Thank you. All right, next we have a presentation, other business, animal shelter discussion. Mr. Sam Hunt. Welcome, sir.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I'm Sam Hunt, and I'm the chairman of the shelter, the Special Shelter Replacement Study Committee. My wife Vicki is chairman of PAWS, which is our Pet Adoption and Welfare Society. You'd be better served if she was speaking, but I'm a poor substitute, and we have our board members. So, first of all, I thank all of you for what you do for our county and for the history of helping to work for the better welfare of our animals. I thank the we've already had two endorsements here before we could get up and start talking, so that's pretty good. And I thank our many, many supporters who are here tonight. The annex is full, and those of you here, it's very important, and we appreciate it. You know, all this started with the shelter when you had that meeting over at the Family Justice Center back in May. And then we came here August 17th to ask that you participate and that you appoint, well, two members of the commission, and it right. turned out that Chairman Engel and Vice Chairman Boswell were our participants. And so the purpose of my visit tonight is to report the results of that study. But before I do, because one member of our study commission was Sheriff Johnson, and Chief Deputy Britt, he's on vacation, which couldn't be better in this kind of weather, and thank God for that, for the sheriff. He certainly deserves it. But Chief Deputy Britt has a message from the sheriff. So.
Very good.
Thank you, Chief Deputy.
I'm up here too much tonight, Chairman. This is from the sheriff wanted me to have some remarks for him. Sheriff Johnson wished to let you know that he cannot be here tonight to speak of his support of building a new animal shelter for Alamance County. He is on a vacation with his wife. Since becoming sheriff in 2002, the current animal shelter has become inadequate. We need additional kennel space, a separate intake area for newly arriving animals, a secure sally port with automatic gates and indoor loading areas that separate the kennels, a larger dedicated office space for the animal control officers to conduct their daily business in. We currently do not have enough office space for the number of personnel we have assigned to animal services. Additionally, cats and dogs need to be housed in separate areas. Simply put, we definitely need a modern animal control shelter that meets the needs of our county and the animals in our county. We cannot continue to put a Band-Aid on important issues such as this. Our citizens, the pets, and animals in this county deserve better. If anyone doubts my observations, I invite them to make arrangements and go out and see the current situation. I'm sure they then will agree with me. In closing, I would like to thank the Shelter Replacement Committee for all of their hard work in this endeavor, and I want to thank you, the commissioners, for your efforts in this matter as well, Sheriff Terry Johnson.
Thank you. Very good.
So anyway, everyone, that's a pretty good message from, and I'll say this, that the sheriff, during our committee meetings, made the point that he you know, they're face-to-face with the public probably more, probably more than y'all are even, but I mean, they're really, you know, there's nothing, it gets people more upset than the animals being mistreated, and he knows that firsthand, and he was a great supporter of our as we worked on this issue. I would refer to the brochure before you, and I would the first page there, and I think everyone, we've passed them out, well, at least one on each row, hopefully. But the members of this committee, we had two, as I said, from the County Commission, Chairman Engel, Vice Chairman Boswell, Craig Honeycutt, the county manager, and Sheriff Johnson. From the city of Graham, we have Lee Kimry from the city council, Ron Klepchak from Alderman, from Elon. We have the chairman of the Alamance County Humane Society. From the city of Burlington, we have Jim Butler, city council, Jeffrey Smythe, the police chief, Kathy Hikes, the city council, Harold Owen, who has been instrumental in getting us to this point, and Jess Arias, who I'll speak of a little bit later, the director of animal services, Rachel Kelly, the public information, David Cheek, the city manager of Mebane, the Friends of Mebane Animals, Renee Bartis, and from our Pet and Adoption Welfare Society, we had Perry Nichols, who all of you know, and Lisa Nichols, Billy Smith, and myself, Vicki, my wife, and Anita. And our charge, so we had I think this was a very broad section in people. And I'll say that as we went through this, it was pretty much unanimous of what we needed to do. And we had meetings, full meetings on September 30th and October 26th. We broke into subcommittees. And our charge was to determine the needs, determine the cost, and how would we pay for it. So that was what we went in to determine. The subcommittee on the needs were Vicki and Jess Arias, chaired it, Chairman Engel and Vice Chairman Boswell were members of that subcommittee, and Lisa Nichols, Renee Bartis, Kelly, Run Out, and the staff from the shelter and the sheriff's department. They met at the shelter. They went through it. We had a video done out there that we didn't bring tonight because it's about 10 minutes long, and I know you would appreciate that, but it is available. Anyone wants to watch it on the Animal Services website, you can go to the and there's a link there that you can do it. Basically, after looking at everything, there was the recommendation was that we must replace the current shelter. There's no way to fix, change, add to, in any way, do anything with what we have. And that they have a needs assessment. This is the best starting point. We need to hire a shelter architect. Because it's very important you have a shelter architect. I've had some experiences in Florida where we didn't hire one and it turned into about $1 million nightmare. So that's very important. And the very details of that, while they have the sort of the base of what they need, you know, when they do the design, they change this and change that. And there'll be a budget of $5.2 million. And not go over the budget. If we have to stop in a room and whatever we have to do, but we feel fairly certain that we can do what we need to do for $5.25 million, and it would probably serve us for the next 25 years. This piece of junk we got now is, you know, 50 years, so I think a good one, and the progress we're making on the whole issue. So that was that. The government, in terms of the how much it would cost and the need, that was that. And then the funding, how we would pay for it, we had a government funding subcommittee, which essentially chaired by Craig Honeycutt and Harold Owen. And so the recommendations were for the government bodies of the county that they would be responsible for $4.5 million of the money. And that all the government bodies would participate on a per capita basis. And when you do it by per capita, of course, Burlington and the unincorporated areas are 70% of the money's there. And it's reasonably close difference. And then Mebane, Graham, and Elon, that's about 14-15% on a per capita basis. And then you have the smaller towns. That's the way we did the pet adoption center, by the way, that we came to you 12 or so years ago, and has proved to be a very valuable thing. And then the private fundraising was Perry Nichols, Bill Smith, and myself. And our PAWS, which is short for Pet Adoption Welfare Society, our board voted that we would guarantee raising $750,000 to add to this. So we would have, what is, in my opinion, the best plan to go forward is when you have the government and the private sector working together to get something done. And we will provide whatever guarantees are appropriate, whether letter of credit or whatever it is, but we will raise the, this is not a promise we'll try to raise, this is, it will be there. And it will be paid. Now, in terms of the government part, some cities may want to pay it all. You know, county may want to pay it all. There may be some borrowing possibilities. But I'm here tonight really to ask for two things. One, that you approve the county doing your part of this. And then if there is going to be a borrowing segment for some of these cities, if they want it, that you be the central borrowing agency, so that, and you would have, in other words, this couldn't be done until you had memorandums of understanding that were binding and that sort of thing. Just like we, PAWS, we're going to provide a guarantee of the, if Burlington's going to sign on, and of course, we'll have to go to these cities, and we're, you know, very optimistic about that. I don't think there's any question that we would get the vast, vast majority of it. Nothing more popular in this county than animals. There's nothing more with more agreement. I mean, I don't care what issue comes up, what party you're in, whatever. It's a very strong support. And so I in this brochure you had, we don't plan to have a number of speakers. Anybody wants to speak, of course, that's up to y'all and how it works. But we thought we would bring you this booklet, which has our results of our study commission, our recommendations. And then as you go through it, you see on the page after our recommendations, you see that we're not meeting the minimum requirements that are put forth. We don't have enough space. The chart shows that. We have here a page that shows what the staff and the volunteers, which this includes the Sheriff's Department, because one thing I saw in the video, the Sheriff's Department has five or six people in a room of no size. You know, I mean, it's just unbelievable, the conditions. But this is what the staff and the volunteers and the sheriff staff, some of the things they said about it, and we just wrote down the highlights. The study, the needs assessment that the city paid for, which is available for anyone to read. There's a page on that, and it sort of shows the layout of where the different rooms will be. The subject to change, of course. A thing that the next page over is a letter from Jess Arias, which is really to her volunteers and her staff, but I thought if anyone takes the time to read it, it really shows that we have a first-class person running this operation. And she's built a staff and a staff of volunteers, and they're, I'll tell you, when I first came here 12 years ago or whatever it was, we were adopted 200, and 200 animals lived that entered the shelter. And today, I think it's 1,800 or 1,900, you can see live release and adoption. Let me get my glasses out.
2,300.
Right.
Jess says 2,300.
2,300. And I mean, that's amazing. with the facilities, I mean, we're just very lucky. And I tell you, one of the things that I worry about is we could lose some of these people if we don't give them a proper place to work. And I have had, I think Jess has already promised them that we're going to build a shelter. So
she's signing.
And of course, she's here. She's here, and Harold Owens here. Craig's involved with him. I mean, you know, anybody would be tickled to death to answer any questions. But you can see where these charts are. And they show where we were in 2009 and then where we are today. And the trend is down in euthanasia. The trend is up in adoptions. The staff and the hard work they're doing is adoptions. Our spay-neuter clinic that we have, Paul's furnished the building. The city furnishes the operation of it. And we're doing about 2,000 spay-neuter operations a year now. The Humane Society is doing a lot of spay-neuter. And then other organizations are promoting it. We have just a number of good animal organizations here in the county, so we're making progress. And then finally at the end, again, I put this in every presentation I ever make, we did a public opinion survey of Alamance County, and of course my theory is people are more animal friendly today than they were 10 years ago, but it shows that, you know, if you look through the highlights of this, the support from the community for spending money for animals, care, treating them right, not abusing them, and having a shelter that's the proper size and capacity and ability is very well supported here. And then, of course, I put in the end a survey that was done by Elon University around this same time. They have a polling. You see them from time to time. I think they're pretty good. But they did a statewide poll, and it's just, I think it's interesting to see. But the bottom line on that is that there's no question that the support is growing. And I think, you know, just to digress politically for a minute, I don't think there's any political support for anyone who's against animals. You know, I'd hate to be running on that platform. I had enough trouble when I ran before. But anyway, on our fundraising, I would mention this. We have had several commitments, major commitments. And one of them, Alan Gant, Glen Raven Mills, has made a significant commitment. And so we feel the we know we're guaranteeing you're going to get the money, but we don't feel like it's going to be a big challenge. So we're glad to answer any questions. We have people here. Oh, I would say that the cities have received a letter, all the cities, that so they will, if they want to think about it for their budgets going forward, Harold and Jeff did send that. And so anyway, I'll be glad to answer any questions, and I know that if you need more information, but from our perspective, this is our presentation, and we would ask you tonight, if you can, to move this ball forward. Questions?
Well, I'd like to make a couple of comments. I just really appreciate the way you've gone about studying this and the group that you've assembled to look at this. I love the fact that this is a community of collaboration. We collaborate in so many ways. And this is a great example, pulling together the municipalities. And you know, I've toured the facility with Jess, and I've seen volunteers there and great staff. And so and with volunteers, you've got transparency in this. And with all the people involved, you have transparency. And this could be a shelter that we could all be proud of, mm-hmm. unlike what we've read about to our neighbor to the west in their shelter. And I just think this is something that we need to move forward on.
So. I agree with you. And one of the first captions you had, existing facility does not meet minimum required standards. And that's what happened in some of our neighboring counties, is they just didn't step up and do what they should have done with their facilities and the people working there. And I was very enlightened with our tour that we took with some of our deputies that work there at the shelter. And some of the things are pretty gruesome, to tell you the truth, because of lack of space. They're having to stay in the rooms with parts of the animal they got to send off for rabies testing, those type of things. So there's two things at issue here. Number one, we're not meeting the standards that the state has set. And number two, we have employees working there that work for the county that are being jeopardized because of the facilities which they have to handle the animals in, outside with no cover a lot of times. And I was very enlightened, you might say, when we did that. One other thing that I would like for Craig or Harold maybe to speak to is the funding part of it from all municipalities within Alamance County. But well, you can do that now or later.
One of the directions we had from the subcommittee was to work and meet with the managers. So Harold and I hosted the municipal managers, gave them the presentation that we talked about during the subcommittee meeting, and we told them that, you know, first we had to start here to make sure that this was a project that the Board of Commissioners wanted to do, but we will be going out and meeting with the municipal managers and the municipal city councils and trying to get their buy-in as well. And it would require a memorandum of understanding to be signed by all the municipalities as well as the county. We will be looking at, as Mr. Hunt said earlier, we would be the funding agent. If any loans would be borrowed, it would be in the county's name, because really shelters are a county responsibility.
Right.
And that's by statute.
I was enlightened by that too.
We've had a wonderful partnership with the city. We've had a wonderful partnership with other municipalities. And if this was approved tonight and there was direction given tonight, well, we have meetings that are set up with the other municipalities. And I appreciate Harold's leadership before he retired on this, and also Jess's as well, in trying to get this coordinated. So, Harold, do you want to?
Well, the reality is, back when I had dark hair, we came up with a challenge, and David, you were brought up, I think, some of this. It was a few years ago. I shouldn't have said it that way, though. In terms of how the operations is funded, the operations of the shelter is funded on a per capita basis. In other words, each year we take the population of each jurisdiction, and that is only the part of the jurisdictions in Alamance County, part of the parts in Mebane that's not, or for that matter, Gibsonville, you know, and a little bit in Berwyn's, not much of. That number is put together, and the remaining population of the county then becomes part of the county. So the funding of the operations of this is based on a per capita basis. Now, it's worked pretty well, if I have to say so myself. Now, the point is that's the philosophy we're taking forward with this, where you know, this is a major capital project, no question. So we ran some numbers based on 15, 20-year debt service. And what it does, it gives the cities and the county an opportunity to pay for it on an annual basis, because this is a facility that's going to last for 20 years. And it takes some of that cost and takes it out over time. And I think what Mr. Hunt was mentioning, it's really up to each individual community how they want to do that. They want to just budget money on an annual basis, as they did for operations for the capital or whatever. Now, when I say operations, there was a small bit of capital put in each year there. The concept here is, we keep talking about the animal, this the shelter. The adoption center was built in early 2004. Now, the concept here was, and when this thing came to me, we challenged our staff to look at it. This is the key here, is putting a facility together and the hopes of saving on operational costs going forward. That's another concept of doing this. And finally, it's been mentioned here, the state has really picked up its statutes concerning what we have to do. We have got by and I have given an awful lot of credit. I was not involved in hiring Jess, but I take full credit for it now. I got full credit for that. But it's an interesting project. It's something that, as we mentioned, I think one of you mentioned the situation in Guilford County. I got pretty serious. Actually got into criminal investigations. And that was contracted out in terms of their operations. So we think this is the best, most efficient way of going forward and fair way for people throughout the community.
And also, this is, would be the capital debt service above and beyond operations. So this is going to be an additional cost for everybody that is involved. So, but again, it would be done on the per capita basis.
Maybe Jess can answer this. Orange County just built one. Do you know the total cost of that facility?
When it was all said and done, it was at $9 million.
$9 million. So if you look and see what we're doing, it's not something that's extravagant here. And
if you look at other shelters that are being built recently throughout the state, we're in that ballpark. They range from about $5 to $6 million on up.
Right.
Okay. Craig, do you have a sense about what the annual debt service would be on any borrowed money that we would?
That is on my desk. I believe it was about $400,000. We were looking at 12 years.
We were looking at 20 years.
Or 20 years.
And the total cost to the county in terms of balance was $1.7 million based over a 20-year period of time.
Let's see, right.
So your annual cost.
Yeah.
Well, that's up to the county, though, borrowing the money. How long they want the agreement for?
That'd be less than $400,000.
Yeah.
Oh, yes. I'm sorry. Yeah. So I was thinking 12 years, but we're probably talking about 200.
I have that correct.
I'm sorry.
Sam's got the final information that we need to make.
No, I forgot something.
To be precise.
Yes, thank you, sir.
If you did it 20 years, the county's share would be $126,000. A year.
So that's in the range where we should be able to work it out somehow
in our budget.
In balancing the budget.
Okay. And Burlington's share would be $131,000 for 15 years. And in 20 years, you pay a little bit more interest if you go from 15 to 20.
Right.
So 70% of the money, as I said, comes from Burlington. And of course, we were going to do 15% of the total. And but for example, Elon would be at 20 years, would be $21,000. So there's no, I think is what Harold's point was, it's not burdensome. It's not mean, it doesn't mean it's nothing, but I mean it's, it is a.
A lawsuit could be a lot more than that if we have an employee get hurt because we didn't do it.
And you know, it's going to get more expensive as we go forward. Yes. So anyway.
Well, and as we get to our budget time, it's just a matter of more prioritizing.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
Sammy, what are you asking for? I'm thick-headed, I guess. I don't understand what you're asking for us to do tonight.
I'm asking, it's what Craig said, I'm asking that you approve this program, that the county would do their part, and that Craig and Harold would go to these other cities, and they would have the option. Maybe they wouldn't decide today. If it went tomorrow, they might not decide tomorrow. Am I going to pay the total amount up front, or I'm going to pay it over time? But the county, if it comes to it and they wanted to borrow, I mean, maybe the city of Burlington might pay theirs up front. I don't know that. It's up to each council. But tonight, I'm asking for two things. One, and I guess it would be all the same, that the county commissioners approve this plan to build a new shelter, and then to instruct the county manager to work with the other municipalities nail down the memorandums of understanding and all that. And so that.
Well, are you asking us to commit to however much money we're talking about the county will be responsible for? Was it $1.7 million? Is that what you said?
The county would be responsible for, exactly 37.98% of $4.5 million. Now, that could, and if they financed it for 20 years, of course, it would be more than than that, but it's almost $2 million, about $1.8 million would be the
total.
The total, but each, if you did it over a 20-year period.
And are we committing to that tonight if we approve it?
Well,
is that what you're saying?
Yeah.
I
would ask you to do that.
I would like, what I'd like to see, I think we need to make sure that our county manager negotiates what we're talking about with the city managers and their governing boards and before we commit. So, well, I'd like to have something etched in stone if we could.
What would help me moving forward would be for this board to say we support the county manager working with the municipalities to come up with a MOU.
Right.
Yes. That everybody can agree upon. And at that point, once we had the MOU in hand, we would then look at bank placements and bank bids and sending out requests for proposals for banking.
To finalize.
And kind of finalize. It is not committing the funds today, but it is committing that we are going down the path to work and to with the ultimate goal of the shelter.
So I'm in favor of that. I can support that.
Yeah.
Because I think it's too premature to actually commit the funds like we're approving a budget.
Yeah. Right.
But we understand the magnitude of what this is going to take.
In other words, we're in support of it.
We're in support of it. Yeah. And,
I'm saying that the county man answered to Commissioner Smith's question. He couldn't have put it better if it had come out of my own mouth. But that's exactly what we hope to do. And then we will then, at the same time when you get your memorandum of understanding, we'll have one with you for the $750,000 that'll be part of the whole thing.
And then bring it all together to make a vote on it at that point in time.
And then that time we will have the numbers tied down. We'll have, you know, who the architect, the whole.
When would that be approximately? Would that?
We have the meetings tentatively scheduled right now with the municipalities for the first week in February, or the first
so
couple weeks in February.
Up quickly.
It will probably. April, we would do everything before our budget is finalized.
Yeah. Right, so that's what I was interested in. I want to kind of do this in conjunction with our budgeting process, too, so that we can see how all the numbers work together.
If the law is that the county is responsible for animal control, the price that Sammy's asking for here, I think, is reasonable for the county to do that. It seems like lately we just keep putting things off, but we need to move. I mean, I was president of the Humane Society in Henderson County many years ago. And I'll tell you, watching these TV ads that come on about these poor dogs and cats that drive me crazy, I have to turn the channel, I can't stand it. So I think we ought to just say, yeah, we're in favor of it, move on.
And
I'm not running for re-election.
And to show that David and I have known each other for a long time, he called me Sammy.
I heard that. If I could say, David and I were commissioners, we were managers at the same time.
Some of the toughest phone calls you get.
Right.
Oh, yeah.
Is on this. I'm telling you.
Try being a chief police 18 years, Earl. I've been there.
It's tough stuff.
Yeah.
Well,
Judge, is that in the form of a motion?
I'll make a motion.
I'll give you a second there, Judge.
Right. We have a motion that we go ahead and approve the county spending of, give me that figure again, Sam.
Approving the plan, and then that, of course, would go along with it.
Yeah. Yeah. And that's approval of the plan and...
And instruct the manager to work with municipalities on the MOU to bring back to you for final approval.
Pending the MOU report from the county manager. How does that sound, Judge? Does that sound good to you?
Sam?
That's the motion then.
That's the motion.
Judge Smith made, and there's a second by Commissioner Boswell. All those in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Thank you, Mr. Hunt.
Thank you.
Yes, sir. Your mascot.
I do want to, if I could ask Jessica a couple questions. We've approved it, but Jessica, in terms of state regulations, I know we're very close, if not in violation. Could you just share some of those with folks here?
I actually have a slide if you want to bring that presentation back up so everybody can kind of see. We're really skating on thin ice, so to speak, you know, even though it is kind of that time of year. But, yeah, and our most recent inspection, which we had in December, if you wouldn't mind, I'm not sure how to, this clicker works.
Yes.
Okay. So our most recent inspection in December, we were found, there were several areas found not acceptable, so we're not in compliance with the state statutes regarding those specific areas of our facility, one of which is ventilation and odor control, and I know you guys can attest to that when you walk through the facility for yourself. And others are enclosures being in sound repair because of damaged areas in the building and surfaces impervious to moisture not being acceptable. We just spent a pretty good chunk of money last fiscal year to re-epoxy the kennel enclosures to seal those concrete and brick areas where the animals are contained in. And they get washed down every day, and the brick's over 55 years old. It just won't hold the paint anymore and won't hold the epoxy that's required to seal those kennels. So it's just a constant issue and a constant drain for our maintenance staff and our budget every year to put these Band-Aids on this old building that's crumbling to pieces, and we're still not meeting minimum required standards.
Thank mm-hmm. you, ma'am. And I personally saw that where you could see new epoxy paint, and it was just coming off in sheets because of the moisture in the walls and the smell. I mean, the ventilation is terrible. So we thank you for it.
Yeah.
Thank you, Mr. Hunt.
Thank you, sir.
Thank all of you. Appreciate
it. Thank you, everybody.
All right. Next on our agenda, we'll give about a minute here.
Yeah. Yes.
Thank you.
That's good.
Chairman, can we make the county manager put his tie on?
Okay. I think we ought to make that a requirement.
Well, I asked him, didn't he keep an extra one in his office? He lost it today when he went to run. Well, crowd here, good
land. Not saying that many people. I've been scared to come in.
My goodness.
That overflow room over to
yes,
the
yes,
overflow, I think. Overflow is overflowing.
I think everybody come back.
Sam
in
got
here.
Him here early, too, did
he? Mr. Chairman, if you want to start over, I'm ready now.
Yeah, I'll see you.
Can we have an official meeting now? Okay.
Next, we have item number two of seven, Tourism Development Authority Quarterly Report. Robert Cox. Welcome, sir.
Commissioners, how are y'all doing this evening?
Fine, thank you.
Good. Boys and Cub Scouts.
I won't take up too much of your time this evening. I just wanted to give a quick update on where we are with tourism. Ending calendar year 2015, some of our numbers we just have are 2014 numbers because one of the reports we get is just issued every August. So for the end of year for 15, we'll see this coming August. But I'll just start here with some of the slides. Now y'all have this in your packet. I'm not sure how easy it is to read, but this first slide here is taken by U.S. Travel Association's Economic Impact Model study that they do for the North Carolina Office of Tourism. And this is where Alamance County ranked for 2014. We had 169.57 million in expenditures with 26.5 million in payroll and approximately 1,330 jobs were attributed to tourism in some aspects.
When you say expenditures, you mean this is what tourists spent in our
countywide, yes. Hotels, restaurants, rental cars, that type of thing. Any other questions on this one? And then this is an actual ranking by tourism expenditures. Alamance County ranks 26th out of 100 counties. It's the fourth from the bottom there. You can see we had, like I said earlier, we had 169.57 million in expenditures, and that was up 3.52% in 14 over 13. And then this is kind of a historical data of where Alamance County ranked since the beginning of this study. It began back in 1990 with tourism expenditures of 57.87 million and has grown steadily to the number I mentioned earlier, 169.57 million. And during that time, we've only had two periods when there was a decrease. One of those was the 2009 year with the whole economic downturn, and then 2002, which was offset by the 9/11 impact on tourism. And then here's some information about our website and how it ranks for 2015. And these are this is January 1 through December 31st of 15. We had 71,736 visitor sessions, with 77.5% of those new visitors and 22.5% were returning visitors. And then the next slide is our referring traffic for 2015, our top five referring websites. VisitNC.com website, which is the Office of Tourism website. The City of Burlington with their .us URL. Elon University, the Chamber, and the City of Burlington with their .gov URL. And then here's how it compares to 2014 visitation session. For 50,498, 79.2 were new visitors, 20.8 were returning visitors. And then just here's just some data on some groups that we served for last year, and the next slide has some information about coming up for this year. We serviced 21 groups for 2015, and that included 13 groups that had overnight stays. We hosted three familiarization trips, which is where we invite people to the community to let them get familiar with what we have to offer in our area. And those included the North Carolina Welcome Centers, guests from the Canadian Automobile Association, some of their salespeople came down, as well as three meeting planners scouting the area for hosting meetings. And then we increased our e-newsletter database from 1,910 recipients to just over 3,000. I think this is the last slide. Some of the large upcoming events we have for this year and a little bit further down the road. The CAA Women's Tennis Championships are in April at Elon, and then the CAA Men's and Women's Track and Field Championships, I believe that's also April. That's two of the first CAA tournament championships that Elon's hosted in the new conference. Conference Carolina Spring Championships and That's a Division II athletic conference, and we host their baseball and softball championships. 2016 and 2017 senior softball national championships. We just found out about 2 months ago that we got the 2017. Co-hosting the 2017 and 2018 North Carolina Powerade State Games, which is a collection of about 25 different sports that are going to be hosted in Greensboro, High Point, Burlington, Alamance County area, as well as Winston. And thanks to all of our partners that we work with, the City of Burlington, Alamance County, for letting us host these great events. That was the last slide.
Mr. Chairman, we appreciate Robert being here. And if you remember, when we passed our memorandum of understanding between us and the TDA, one of the agreements on that was that Robert would come and provide quarterly presentations and updates. And we really do appreciate work that the TDA is doing and the TDA board is. And if you remember, they're funded as a pass-through from Alamance County through the 3% occupancy tax. So that is the reason why Robert is so intricately involved in what we do in county government and how important the TDA is.
Thank you. Any questions?
Sounds like a great report. A
lot of good stuff going on in Alamance County, right?
Yes, sir.
Thank you for your report, Robert. Appreciate it. Thank you. Next, we have the FJC grant submission, Ms. Offerman and Ms. Prey.
So Bob was talking about collaboration earlier, and FJC is a very fine example of that. And it's really great how this came together. So I'm asking for permission to write two grants. One of them is a funding stream from the Governor's Crime Commission, and this year they have decided to make Family Justice Centers a priority. And it just so happens that thanks to the partners' willingness to get together and do a strategic plan, we were ready for it. So we did a strategic plan last April and talked about expanding services and expanding the scope of services and building security and several different things. So these Governor Crime Commission funds are going to help us do that. The other grant is a grant to end abuse later in life, and that is a federal grant. Very heavily about training law enforcement, judicial officials to identify and respond to elder abuse, which has tripled since about 2011. It's a 3-year grant and it's $400,000, with part of that going to direct services to address respite services and in-home services for people who need that while we're trying to figure out a plan.
I'd just like to add, you know, sometimes when grant opportunities come before us, we think, what can we do with those funds? But because of the planning and the collaboration and partnerships, we're in a position at the Family Justice Center and in this community to say, these are our needs, and this is how these funding opportunities move us along. And so I think that's a great position for our community to be in, and I think that's how we're moving forward.
And one of the priorities for moving forward was to address elder abuse, and
which is very important.
So it
and
is
growing.
And growing. And so I would like to request your approval to submit these two grants. One of them's due February the 11th, and the other one's due January 30th.
Do we need to do them?
The match.
Yep.
So the Governor's Crime Commission is a 20% match.
Okay.
But you can get that in kind. We have that in volunteer.
You already have that already taken care of, right?
Mm-hmm. Yes, it can be in kind or cash, and we've got the in kind. Okay. The federal grant does not require a match.
It's a no-brainer then.
So moved.
I'll second that. Okay. I'm quick on the draw tonight. I have a motion and a second. You have some guests here with you tonight, I think.
We do.
Dignitaries.
We have Tim Britt from the Sheriff's Office. He was here. But he's a partner on the advisory board. Jeffrey Smythe, Chief Smythe.
Chief.
Assistant Chief Dixon from the Gibsonville Police Department, Chief. And Chief Parker.
Thank you. Welcome.
Glad to have y'all with us.
One thing I noticed is that on the federal application, there are a lot of sort of bureaucratic requirements. I guess we're up to meeting almost.
So if you want to hear the story, I mean, we were going to apply last year and decided to postpone it and work on it all year long. We would have never, I don't think we could have gotten ready. So we have been working on this for quite some time.
You've been planning a long time for it.
Our district attorney has been a mover on making sure we don't miss this opportunity.
And it ties very much in with a previous initiative that DSS and law enforcement and the DA's offices put together, so.
Thank you. And Judge, just for the public, we're going to vote on separately. One's a state grant and one's a federal grant.
Right.
Judge has made a motion, seconded by Commissioner Byrd on the Governor's Crime Commission grant. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. All right. Do I have a motion for approval of the federal grant?
Same motion.
I have a motion.
Second.
All right. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All right. Both
agree. All right.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Next, we have budget amendments. The Health Department. Ms. Saunders, is she here?
I don't think she's here. Where's she? Craig, is she here?
Yep.
She's gone. No, she's back here taking a nap.
Welcome.
Good evening.
I thought you snuck out.
So we have three budget amendments, and if it's okay with you all, we'd like to address the budget amendment for Agreement Addenda 164, which is for $20,000.
Okay.
And sort of falling in line with what you just heard, the first two allocations for budget amendments that you're going to hear fall in line with a larger community initiative that we have, which is Strive Together, our collective impact sort of initiative that we have. And I would like to introduce Shelby Smith, who is our Elon Alamance Health Partner, postgraduate fellow here at the Health Department with me, to present the budget amendment for 164 for you.
Very good.
Good evening, Commissioners, and thank you for the opportunity to allow me to speak to you this evening. The Alamance County Health Department, as Stacy said, has received an allocation of $20,000 from the North Carolina Division of Public Health as part of a statewide effort to improve maternal and child health outcomes. Based on Session Law 2015-241, the General Assembly stated that beginning in the 2016-17 fiscal year, the division will implement a competitive grants process for local health departments based on maternal child health data indicators and a county's detailed proposal. This proposal should be focused on evidence-based programs that are scientifically proven to lower infant mortality rates, improve birth outcomes, and improve the overall health of children ages 0 to 5. This $20,000 allocation is the precursor to this competitive grant process and is to be used specifically to complete planning and capacity building activities for a team of public health professionals, community partners, and family consumers of our services engaged in maternal and child health. We see this as an opportunity to tie in the work of the Health Department, like Stacy said, to our local collective impact framework, Strive Together, and to enhance current programs offered community-wide. These are entirely state funds and do not require any local match or expenditure of any local funds.
Very good.
Thank you. So the first grant is for $20,000 from the Division of Public Health. Do I have a motion?
Motion to approve.
All right.
Second.
All right. Motion to second. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
So the second one is very similar in nature in its focus area of infant mortality reduction, but it is a separate allocation from the Department of the Division of Public Health. And it is called Agreement Addenda 165. And this allocation, again, came through the General Assembly. They set aside some money in the Maternal Child Block Grant, which is a large funding stream, to redistribute to counties with high infant mortality rates for the time period of 2010 to 2014. We are one of those counties receiving money to implement certain evidence-based programming that is different than the allocation that you just heard of. So just to give you a little bit of a brief overview, our overall infant mortality rate for that five-year period of time was 8.5 deaths per 1,000 live births. It also sort of highlights that we still have a disparity when it comes to our white to minority infant mortality, and we have about a 2 times more likely infant mortality rate in our minority than we do in our white population. So still an area for us to be looking at and doing work in. So the funds in this allocation would be likely to be used in our centering our long-acting reversible contraceptives at the Health Department, Safe Sleep, and potentially our 17 program, which helps to prevent second preterm deliveries or subsequent preterm deliveries.
And there's no match on this item?
No.
So.
These are all state funds.
This is $113,750 from the Division of Public Health, the Infant Mortality Reduction Grant. I have a motion from Commissioner Boswell.
Yes.
I have a second.
Second.
All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Thank you.
And the last one that you have is not state at all. It is a Delta Dental Foundation grant in the amount of $3,000 for our children's dental health clinic. And these funds will be used for equipment, including isolights and curing lights that they use in the children's dental clinic. No match for this as well, just all foundation.
Is that where they're going out to the public schools and teeth? Is that the
no,
same
the, so our state dental hygienist through the Division of Public Health does a lot of that work. These would be used in our children's dental clinic on McKinney Street in Burlington.
Okay. So it's in the clinic.
That's
right.
Correct.
Right.
$3,000 grant from Delta Dental.
I move approval of the
have a motion. I have a second.
Second.
Second. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed, no. Thank you.
Thank you all so much.
Appreciate
thank
it.
You. Thank you, Stacy.
All right, next we have John Payne, Fire Marshal's Office, budget amendment.
Thank you, Chairman and Commissioners. Three out of the last 4 years, Alamance County has been fortunate enough to receive the HMEP grant, which is the Hazard Materials Exercise Preparedness Grant. 2012, we conducted a chemical leak at the water treatment plant in Burlington. 2013, we had a active shooter drill at Alamance Community College. 2015, last year, we had a chemical leak out of a tanker truck at Walter Keady plant in Mevin. I don't know if anyone was able to attend or not. We were very fortunate to receive the grant again this year for $9,500. We need a budget amendment for that. We were all planning, not to let the specifics out, we're all planning a tanker truck and a train collision in the western part of the county where it's highly populated. So we are asking for a budget amendment for $9,500. It is fully reimbursable by the state once we finish the drill and we'll get our proper paperwork signed and back to the state.
And this drill involves the hospital and local law
hospital, local law, EMS, fire, emergency management.
Right.
Yes, sir.
You know, given the amount of hazardous chemicals that come through this community on the interstate and two interstates and the rail,
yes, sir.
Is something we need to do.
I will,
yes, sir.
I will make motion to approve this $9,500 grant.
Do I have a second?
Second.
Have
a second. Any further discussion? All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, yeah. No. Thank you.
Thank you.
Mr. Chairman, I can't mention, I appreciate the work Johnny's done, you know, with Dave Leonard retiring, Johnny Septon's fire marshal, and we do really appreciate the work, and he has really stepped up and done a great job. We
thank
just
you.
Want to publicly say
well,
that.
They do a
thank
good
you.
Job. I was in
thank
on the
John.
Shooter thing at yeah. the community college a couple of years ago, and that was, they found out a lot of things they didn't really know.
Next, we have budget amendment and inspections. Susan, you gonna do that?
I'm gonna handle that one.
All right. Well.
Good evening, Commissioners.
Good evening.
As you will remember, at last meeting, there was a position approved for the inspections department. This will allocate $61,546.63, and that money will be taken from his fees that have already increased through the fiscal year.
All right. Any questions?
Nope.
All right. I move approval.
I'll second that.
Motion second. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed, no. Thank you. Next.
You're welcome. I've got the next one.
All right.
What I'm asking for tonight is for us to be able to close out our CDBG grant fund. And with that, we will actually get our actuals to expended budgeted, as well as a transfer from the general fund of $1,435.52 to take care of all the expenses.
So I didn't understand when I read this what you mean by closing out.
Those projects have been completed, and now we need to get our budget in line to the monies that were actually received to what was actually expended.
Okay, so it's a kind of a reconciliation.
Exactly.
Balance.
This is just balancing out and
right.
reconciling
yeah.
everything.
Right. And so we only need $1,400 out of the fund to reconcile. That's pretty good.
I'll make a motion to approve.
All right. Approval of closing the CDBG grant. Do I hear a second?
Second.
All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no.
You.
Thank you. All right, I guess we're down to the county manager's report.
Mr. Chairman, if I could, notice we had a group of Weebles here, and didn't know if they wanted to introduce themselves.
I was going to recognize them, but this is a good time.
I'm sorry, that's a good time.
Please do.
Yes, stand up. I'm John Presley. We're from Grove Park Baptist Church. Weeble ones, and we came here tonight as part of working on a better world, and we got to see a lot of that in action today. So, thank you, guys.
Welcome, guys.
Welcome.
Yes.
Sorry, Mr. Chairman, didn't mean to.
That's okay.
But also, just a very quick, I wanted to mention we have our next countywide strategic planning forum, which is on Monday, January 25th at the Mebane Arts Center at Arts and Community Center at 6 p.m. So invite everybody to attend. The last
I think that's right.
I've got 25th.
I've got Tuesday the 26th on my calendar.
Okay, Tuesday, January 26th at the Mebane Arts Center.
There's Libby, she knows.
Is it 26, right, Libby?
26. Yeah. We have one at Fawcett Fire Department on the 25th.
Okay, so we have.
Oh, no, thanks, Libby. So we do. I also want to thank those that attended our strategic planning meeting on January 12th at Elon. Appreciate Commissioner Byrd and also Commissioner Boswell for being there. It was well attended. We had probably 30 staff and citizens attend. A lot of good information was given. I want to thank Shelby. Where's Shelby? Shelby helped facilitate, who was just here with the health department, and MJ helped facilitate the meeting, and it went really, really well, and just wanted to give a plug in for that.
So, and we're getting a lot of input from our citizens, and that's what it's about.
That's what it's about.
And that's all I have.
Thank you very much. This time, I'd like to move that we go into closed session pursuant to North Carolina General Statute, Section 143-318.11A3, in order to preserve the attorney-client privilege between the county attorney and the Board of Commissioners, and receive a report regarding the appeal of the court's dismissal of the United States versus Terry S. Johnson, Sheriff of Alamance County. Do I have a second on that motion?
Second that motion.
All right, all those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. We'll be adjourned and going into closed session this time.
And his boss believed him.
All right, back in session, board considered statements. We received statements from the county attorney concerning the appeal by the United States Department of Justice. No action was taken. Next, we have commissioners' comments. Who'd like to start?
I'm good.
All right.
I don't have any.
Linda?
I'm good.
Judge?
I'd just like to know the progress of the Conodal Clinic renovations. Where do we stand on that?
We are haven't done it. We have accepted, I think the deed has been done.
Oh, the deed was reported the 18th.
Somebody's over there cleaning out stuff, though. I rode by there the other day, and I saw some dumpsters and stuff.
A bunch of dumpsters there? Oh, good.
We've been working with them as far as their existing equipment, some existing records.
Okay, is that what it was?
But as far as renovations, we have not approved anything at this point. One of the things that we do need to get back on schedule is talking about our facilities and the needs and next steps, because we do have a lot of facility needs. We did kind of put that on hold so we could accept the Cronodal building to see how that fit in our overall facilities plan. But we do need to start having that discussion on what's the next steps.
And we've insured it.
Right.
The next
step to me seems like it should be that management should come to the board with a plan on what to should be done and start moving on the thing. We've got departments that's sitting on top of each other, and we got plenty of room over there, and it's going to take a long time. Is there any stuff that got to be taken out of the building?
We could start doing a lot of things
and incorporating it into the facilities plan and determine exactly who needs to move in there, which I think all of us got a pretty good idea who needs to go over there.
And we have some, you know, there's some issues also with the old computer training center over at DSS. Mm-hmm. You know, we closed that down because of, you know, just kind of falling in. Mm-hmm. So there's space issues for NC Pass, there's space issues for planning, there's space issues for inspections. But yes, now that we have it under our preview, we need to begin setting up plans and moving forward, and I agree with the judge on that.
I feel like we need to take a more comprehensive approach to building plan, because we have, how many buildings do we have? It's a large number.
A lot of square footage.
38.
And do we know that we have the right adjacencies with people to be able to leverage the most efficiencies? You know, sometimes it makes a difference as to who we're working next to.
Yeah. And putting departments that need to be together.
Yeah, and where people can share, support staff and all kinds of opportunities for efficiencies.
And I think this building will be a kind of what we need to look at for possibility,
but
we've got to do the overall first.
And I don't know if we've done a good job of assessing all of our buildings with respect to roof needs and what's the life of roofs and HVAC systems and chillers and, you know, all these very expensive things.
We've had studies on that in the past.
Is the jail dry?
The jail is dry. We are closing out. Richard met with the contractor yesterday. I think there were some minor things that need very
coping. He finally got the coping up.
Around the edge.
We're able to cope. And I think the roof's done.
Yeah, they were finishing up today.
Yeah.
But there is no leaks, and even through all the rain we've had. So now it comes to the point of settle. And
waiting on a big rain.
We have some issues that we do need to bring up and as far as closing that out.
I would suggest that we do move forward to set up some meeting to sit down and let's look at what we need to.
Yes, sir.
I appreciate that, Judge.
Yeah, we need to expedite that.
They approved the 20-year warranty. We did that today.
Yeah. All right. Any further comments?
We'll move forward.
Meeting adjourned.
Thank you for watching the Alamance County Commissioners Meeting. Meetings of the Commissioners Board occur on the first and third Monday of each month in the Commissioners' Chambers on the second floor of the County Office Building, located at 124 West Elm Street in Graham. Typically, the first meeting of the month is held at 9 a.m., and the second meeting is held at 7 p.m. Changes to the meeting schedule will be posted on the Commissioners' website at www.alamance-nc.com. You can watch the most recent meeting of the Commissioners on the second and fourth Wednesday of each month on Time Warner's local public access channel, beginning at 10 p.m. You can also watch recordings of the most recent meeting and past meetings by going to our website at www.alamance-nc.com. Please visit our website for more information on watching Commissioner meetings online. For technical questions regarding this meeting's online or television broadcast, please contact our county webmaster at webmaster@alamance-nc.com. Please note that this address is for technical questions only. Questions or comments regarding the content of the commissioners' meetings may be made to the commissioners themselves. You can find their contact information on the Alamance County website at www.alamance-nc.com. Click on the link that says County Commissioners to visit the Commissioners' website, where you can learn about our Commissioners, read minutes of past meetings, access agendas, and find other information about our Board of Commissioners. You can also send mail correspondence to the County Commissioners by addressing it to the Alamance County Commissioners, 124 West Elm Street, Graham, North Carolina, 27253. Again, thank you for tuning in to the Alamance County Commissioners meeting.